Today, we will categorize based upon our working conditions, the types of the working conditions which are generally provided by the organized and the unorganized sector. Organized and unorganized sector. Working conditions in the sense, the nature of a job, what kind of the facilities which are given by the employer to their employees, what kind of the services which are basically provided by the employer to their employees. That sector which generally provides the such facilities to their workforce, to their employees, they are categorized under the organized sector. They are generally categorized under the organized sector. Organized sector. When we are talking about a term about the organized sector, the first aspect which comes in our mind as the that sector which has basically governed by the government or either the public sector, the part of the public sector. But there are some number of private enterprises are there, private enterprises which are also categorized under the organized sector. Why? Because they are following the such number of rules and regulations which are followed under the government sector, which are followed under the government sector. The Central Statistical Organization, Central Statistical Organization, which is generally known for the, it is generally known for the conduct of a surveys, economic surveys, which are basically conducted by the CSO, and that authority given their data to the government agencies, to the government for the formulation of a policies. Such economic policies which are basically work for the beneficial of society, beneficial of people. For example, if in an economic survey, if on a report of a Central Statistical Organization, it is marked that the any particular area is basically affected by the unemployment, where the job opportunities are not adequate. So as per the data given by the CSO, government, it will formulate their policies, such policies which target to the such sections which are basically affected by the unemployment. For example, MNREGA. MNREGA, it will be as actively work in a such areas where the job opportunities are the lesser or the more people are unemployed in rural areas. Clear? So the Central Statistical Organization defines the organized sector as all enterprises that are either registered or come under the preview of any of the acts. This agency, Central Statistical Organization, it defines the organized sector as the enterprise that are either registered means that particular firm which has following as the rules and regulations, registered or come under the preview of any of the act and or maintain annual accounts and maintain balance sheets are categorized or are known as the organized sector. They are known as the organized sector. All other enterprises are included in the non-organized sector. So except them, the others are categorized under the non-organized or the unorganized, which are not registered or not followed any kind of rules and regulations. Organized sector includes all public sector establishments and private sector establishments registered under one or the other acts. They are following as a one or other different kinds of acts in favor of employees. For example, what kinds of the acts which are generally followed under organized sector. For example, first, Minimum Wages Act. In every year, as the minimum wages, it has set or the modified by the reviewed by the government of India. So as for the present a worker which has doing the work in a construction site, it has generally earned 400 rupees in a day. This is as a minimum wage. Minimum wage. If any of our employer, when they provide as a jobs, then they can't pay less than the 400. They can't pay less than 400. This is as a set criteria which will be followed by the all the employers. They can increase the salary as per the qualifications, professional degrees, or the experience. As per the experience, the salary of our employees, it can be as an increase, but neither decrease. Neither decrease of a minimum wages. Clear? It can't be as a decrease as compared to the minimum wages. Second one is a payment of a gratuity act. Payment of gratuity act. Gratuity act. Gratuity is what? Gratuity is generally as the extra income paid by the employer. Gratuity is the extra income paid by employer to their employees for their regularity in job. For example, a person which has employed in any of a firm, any of a organization for more than the 5 years, minimum 5 years is required for the gratuity. So person already worked in that particular firm since last five years. When the 5 years, it will be as a cross, then it will be as comes under the gratuity. Gratuity means when the person, it will left the job. In any of the circumstances, it is retired or either it leave the job, resigned from their post after the 5 years. Then under such circumstances, for every year of experience, there will be as a 15 days of extra income paid by the employer. 15 days of extra income for the 1 year, multiply 5, because 5 years of experience possessed by the individual, that employee. Clear? Gratuity is an extra income which is paid by the employer to the employees for their regularities. Clear? Third one is a societies, cooperative societies act. Cooperative societies act. Cooperative societies act. Cooperative societies act. So that this act has basically followed. This act is basically followed in a rural, those firms which are work in a rural areas. In rural areas. Generally work in a rural areas. So cooperative societies act, such group. Cooperative societies are the those group which are work on a mutual benefits, which are work for the mutual benefits of the locality. Such are the cooperative societies. Cooperative societies, they are known as the cooperative societies. Next one is the shops and Establishment Act. Shops and Establishment Act. It means Shops and Establishment Act means that all those firms, all the organizations or industries, industries are generally constructed in areas far away from the residential areas. Industries are neither preferred to locate in a residential areas. These are located at the outskirts of the cities, outskirts at the margins of the cities where the people are not preferring to live, where the population is not inhabiting in such of the lands. These are occupied under the industries because the type of the pollutions which are caused due to the industries, it will not harm to the people. It will not harm to people. Clear? Is that clear? It will not harm to people. It will not harm to people. So these are a certain number of acts which are followed by the employers in organized sector. Except these acts, there are a certain number of facilities provided by the employer to the employees in an organized sector. Employers to their employees in an organized sector. What are these? First, services. What kind of the services? First, regular. Nature of a job is a regular. Regular jobs. Nature of job is a regular. Clear? Regular jobs. It means that the person, it will be not relieved from their services by the employer on an uncertain time. Uncertain. Clear? Second one, fixed number of working hours. Fixed number of working hours. Working hours. So as per the government rules and regulations, 8 hours minimum, 8 hours, these are set in all the organizations for working hours. 8 hours. If a person has doing the more work as compared to the 8 hours, then there is a provision of overtime. In organized sector, there is a provision of overtime, extra income for the extra work. But such facilities are not provided in an unorganized sector. Such facilities are not provided in unorganized sector. Clear? Next one. Fourth, paid leaves. Paid leaves. Paid leaves. In any of a state, if the employees, they are taking as the leaves from their leave. Leave means as a casual leave for a 1-2 days or a medical leave for a 10-20 days. Under such circumstances, there is a provision of a payments. Payments for the leaves. Payments for their leaves. This is as also the followed under the organized sector. But in unorganized sector, if a person has not coming towards their working site, then the employers, they are deducting their salaries. There is no provision of a paid leaves in unorganized sector. Understood? Next, fifth, allowances. There is a provision of allowances. Different number of allowances. Allowances means as a extra or a supportive income. With the basic income, the total income, there is a certain number of allowances given by the employer to their employees. Employer to their employees. For example, as per the increasing the prices hike in a petrol, hike in prices of a petrol, there will be as the inflation will rise. Inflation, hike in prices of goods. Hike in prices of goods. Under such circumstances, employer has offered the DA, domestic allowance. DA, domestic allowance. When inflation increases, under such circumstances, employer offered to their employees as the DA. Clear? Domestic allowance. Second, TA, transport allowance. Transport allowance. Transport allowance means the person which has employed in a Ludhiana but living in a Jalandhar. Living in Jalandhar. So Jalandhar to Ludhiana, 60 kilometers, it has traveled to the any of a vehicle as per their own or the public vehicle. It has opted as a public vehicle. Under such circumstances, employer given as the income, extra income in support to avail the such transport expenses, transport allowance. Next is HRA, housing and rental allowance. Housing and rental allowance means if a person belong from a Jalandhar, moving towards a Ludhiana and taking as a apartment on rent. The person which is living on rent in Ludhiana, under such circumstances, employer has offered or given as the housing and rental allowance, the extra income for their living in that particular city. That particular city, if a person living nearer the sources of their work or a job, under such circumstances, employers, they are offered as the HRA, Housing and Rental Allowance. Housing and Rental Allowance. Clear? One more facility is there, Provident Funds. Provident Fund is what? There is a sum of the share of income. It is procured by the or deposited by the employer in a employee's provident fund. There is an organization which has basically used such share of employees, and the same share it has collected from the employer also. Means there is a worker which is working in any of a firm, any of a organization. Some of their share, 3% of their total income, it will be as collected from the worker, and 3% same as collected from the employer. It will be as a deposited. When an employee, it will relieve from their services, either as the retirement or resigned from their post. Under such circumstances, that particular person, it can be as a withdraw such amount of money which deposited in a form of provident fund. This is as the security which can be as used by the employees after the leaving of their jobs or at the time of retirement. Earlier, this was used for the pensions. Remember, pensions. But after the 2006 government of India, it finished its rule of a pension scheme. Now, after the 2006, all those people, individuals which employed, they are basically saving their some share of the income in a form of a provident fund. And when they leave their jobs, they withdraw that money and use for their beneficial. Clear? So all such kind of services and those four acts are followed under the organized sector. They are followed under the organized sector. The unorganized sector is beyond the control of the government. They do and follow the rules and regulations as per their own. In this sector, jobs are not secure. In unorganized sector, jobs are not secure. There is generally as the jobs provided to the people in unorganized sector as the temporary jobs. Nature of job is a temporary. Means people or employees, they are basically employed for the 1 year, 2 year, or a for short tenure of time. After 2-3 years, employers remove the employees from their working sites and employed the newer one. So it means their regularity, they disrupted. When the regularity of a job is not there, means gratuity, it can't be as applicable on such institutes. Such type of the firms, they are not following the gratuity. Clear? In unorganized sector, gratuity has not followed by them. There are no fixed number of working of hours in a unorganized sector. In unorganized sector, there is no provision of a fixed number of working hours or no overtime. Most number of private firms, they are taking the services more than the 8 hours from their workers and not paid them the overtime. They are generally not paid them overtime. There is no provision of a paid leaves in an unorganized sector. In unorganized sector, there is no provision of paid leaves. If a person not coming towards their working sites at their jobs, then there will be as a deduction in their total salary, the gross salary, which will be as a paid after the completion of the month. There will be as a deduction. And some of the private firms are there which are deducting as not for the one day, for a one leave, they are deducting as 2 to 3 days of 2 to 3 days of their salary. This is as the economic exploitation. Economic exploitation. Next one, no provision of the allowances are there. No extra allowances are paid by the employer to their employees. No provision of extra allowances paid by the employer to their employees, and no provision of a provident fund. No provision of provident fund. No provision of an employee's provident fund. Clear? This is as the unorganized sector. This is as the unorganized sector. In this sector, jobs are not regular. Jobs are not regular. They are not secured. There is no provision of the overtime. No paid leaves are there. And when there is less work, some of the workers may be asked to leave by the employer. For example, during this time of a lockdown, a large number of private firms or firms under the unorganized sector, they force their workforce to leave it, to leave, because if the production will not occur, how can an employer it avail the salaries of their employees? So most number of the employers, they force their workforce to leave it. So workers have to work as per the terms and conditions marked by the employers. Terms and conditions, more number of the working hours are there. If you are ready to work, then they are welcome. They are paid as a less salaries, with less salaries, less than as a minimum wages act. Less than the minimum wages act. So this is as economic exploitation. Economic exploitation. In an unorganized sector, there is no provision of appointment letters. In organized sector, appointment letters are given by the employer to their employees. But in unorganized sector, no provision of any appointment letter. This sector includes the large number of people doing the small jobs, such as the selling on the streets, during the repair work, landless laborers, weavers, carpenters, blacksmiths, laborers engaged in construction sites, painters, masons, etc. So all these are categorized under the unorganized sector. You can see them. There are a large number of people which are waiting for the employment, for the jobs in a road crossings. For example, the Kapurthala Chowk on a Tanda Chowk, Mahira Gate, and the third one as a Rama Mandi. There are a large number of workforces waiting for their employers, for the jobs. People going towards such areas for hiring the such people for 1 or 2 days. They are bargaining like as in shops, bargaining for their salaries. So minimum wages set as a 400 rupees, but they are paid as a less than the minimum wages. But such workers, they are bound to work at the low wages because jobs are not there. Supply of the workers is more comparatively their demand. Comparatively the job opportunities. Under such circumstances, the economic exploitation, or people are economically exploited in economy. People are generally exploited in economy. So there is a structural change in the Indian economy in favor of the organized sector, but it still continues to occupy a minor place. The organized sector dominates the economy with the 2/3 of the national income. The unorganized sector is to be found in the agriculture and all other spheres of economic activities, including the manufacturing and the service sectors. Clear? Till there, any doubts? This is as the difference in between of an organized and unorganized sector. Organized and unorganized sector. Organized and unorganized sectors. Now the next question arises there. How can we protect the workers in an unorganized sector? That sector where the more exploitation with the workers done by the employers. Employees employees exploited by the employers. How can we protect such workers in unorganized sector? Unorganized sector. How can we protect the workers in unorganized sector? So here are a large, any doubts till there, the difference between of organized and unorganized sector. Any doubts, any questions? So a large number of people are working in an unorganized sector. The job opportunities in the organized sector are not encouraging. So people compelled to job in unorganized sector. This sector pays very low income, very low salaries, and does not follow any rules and regulations. Does not follow any rules and regulations and law. Rules and regulations and law, which formulated by the government through the constitution. Workers are paid less and get exploited by the employer. A large number of the workers lost their jobs in the organized sector after the economic reforms of 1991. In 1991, severe economic crisis occurred in Indian economy. In Indian economy, under such circumstances, the existing Congress government, it was their finance department managed by Manmohan Singh, Dr. Manmohan Singh, it adopted the policy of a liberalization. In 1991, Manmohan Singh or Indian government, it accepted, it followed the policy of a liberalization. Liberalization means it liberalized their policies in relation to the foreign direct investment. Such foreigners, which were earlier restricted by the Indian government, to encourage the local producers in a manufacturing sector, such restrictions removed by the existing government, and the foreign direct investment to which the large number of multinational corporations, multinational companies, MNCs, these were set up in our country, especially as the computer software-based industries. So that kind of educated unemployed, which generally moving towards other countries, they got the jobs in a larger number. Then India, it followed the policy of a globalization and privatization. Globalization means interlinking of world economies. Those goods which are not manufactured in our country. These are imported towards our country, and those goods which are produced in abundance, these exported towards the other countries under this globalization. The world, it becomes as the global village. Then as a privatization, those number of reforms which earlier managed by the government, now these were handled by such a number of reforms, these handled by the private sector, but not as a fully 50-50% as the half of the shares. For example, Punjab State Electricity Board. Before of 2007, it was managed under the public sector through the government agency, in which as a most number of electricity, it was given as the free of cost. But under such circumstances, the large number of power cuts also occurred. But after the 2007, when the privatization, it opted in a Punjab State Electricity Board, afterwards, the service of a power, it improved. In a rural as well as the urban areas. Regular supply of electricity. Government now presently has a responsible for purchasing of a power, purchasing of electricity from Heidel Power Station, from Bhakhra Nangal Power Station, from their dam, and three of the thermal power stations located in India, which are completing our power requirement. And a private sector is responsible. Private sector is responsible for the distribution, for providing the services, service of the power distribution. Clear? Yes, Dhavnish, raise your hand. Dhavnish, Tenthi, raise your hand. In an unorganized sector, where there are no surety of a jobs. No surety of a jobs. Yes, Aryansh. Aryansh, raise your hand. Where for their rights. Clear? Tomorrow we will start from this. How can we as protect the workers in an unorganized